everyone. Oh my gosh. I cannot tell you how excited I am for this video. I am joined by the fabulous, the gorgeous, the stunning Veronica Blades. Hello, my love. Oh. So, people who don't know, Veronica is my piercer. Mine only. I have invited her onto the channel because I want to do some piercing confessions. And you guys always ask me, like, some questions, things that I can't answer or things just about piercings. And I'm like, well, let's have the professional with me.
Always listen to your piercers. Mm-hmm. You know, each piercer might have different opinion and it's fine.
But yours is the right opinion.
Exactly. That's mine, nobody's else. Exactly.
Okay, so first of all, how long have you been piercing for?
I've been a body piercer for 15 years now.
15, oh, okay, gosh. And when did you start that? Like, what got you into doing that?
My journey with piercing starts when first I saw a body piercing in TV, because in my small town, like, nobody used to have piercing, so I haven't seen it before.
Yeah.
And then I was like, wow, that looks nice.
How old were you then, sorry?
I was 16, okay. I guess. Mm-hmm. But then I waited till I was 18. I went to a professional tattoo shop to get it done.
With a piercing gun, a class accessory.
No. And then I started to pay more attention to piercings on people. Obviously, usually like ear piercings. And then I was going to bigger cities and so I noticed even more. And I was like, quite a lot of them are not done properly. So I'm like, hey, maybe we can fix it somehow. And that's how I started to, you know, read, check things, experiment on myself, on my friends. And then I started to travel around my country, you know, to do those things. And things picked up and...
Yeah, now you're here.
Yeah.
What are some of your, like, favorite piercings that you love to do? When you hear someone say, you're like, oh, thank God.
Funny enough, genital piercings.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, and usually on couples. I don't know, do you know, but female genital
piercings... Females illegal now, yeah.
...are illegal in the UK, because technically, as a woman, you don't have right to decide about
your
own body.
Stupid.
There we go. I love to do genital piercings on gay couples, you know, because it's like... so bonding, and that I can be part of the process, you know, I just love it. You know how much I love my gays?
Yes!
And especially, you know, in this, that I can somehow be part of their journey, you know?
What are some piercings that, like, when you hear you're going to do them, you're like, oh God, I don't want to do that, or like, is there any piercings that you just feel uncomfortable doing?
I don't have piercings like, oh my God, I hate this one. No. With me, it's usually about the person. What I love to do is like projects of piercings, when someone's got an idea of something, you know, and adding few more, so it will be one cohesive piece.
Yeah, that's cool.
So that's what I like.
So just a tiny extension just to that one as well. Is there any piercings that carry slight risks that you're sort of, you generally say to people, like, you really need to think about this before you get it done?
Yeah, there are a lot of piercings that we don't do at my studio, you know, it's because most of them, you know, they won't heal or they can leave extra scarring or they've got risks and so.
Yeah.
Like, for instance, cheek piercings, you know, they heal, you know, sure, they might heal nicely, but if they don't, you know, you might need reconstruction, you know?
Yeah.
Because, yeah, you might have, like, saliva going through it, you know, like, I had mine, you know, I was eating chocolate and someone was like, oh, you're bleeding, I was like, no, it's chocolate, you know what I mean? Like, yeah, it happens, you know, but you don't expect anybody who has, like, cheek piercing that it will happen to them. No, of course not. That's one of the reasons. There are piercings, for instance, like a mandible piercing, that this one, if it gets infected, you know, like, then it might be a serious risk to your life.
I just can't imagine how much force you'll need to push all that through there. Like,
the needles are sharp.
What are some irritating, kind of stupid questions that you get often?
Obviously, the most annoying question is, does it hurt?
Yes.
It depends on the person, you know, so many factors that this is such a random question. Or, can we do it cheaper?
Cheaper?
Or, yeah, can my family come with me? And then you've got people coming in with 8 people and their dog, their cat, their goldfish, you know, and they're like, can all of us come and watch? No, this is just between you and, you know, and the piercer.
Yeah, for sure.
You know, you need to focus, you know?
So I always get questions to me, why do I never film the piercings being done? But I've never been in a piercing studio where they've allowed you to film inside anyway. I'm like, is that a common thing?
Yeah, it's a common thing. I had customers who never asked me about it. They were like this. And I'm like, can you look at me?
Yeah.
It's so disrespectful.
Well, the thing is, like, that as well, but also, like, it puts so much more pressure on you as well. Because it's that kind of like, oh shit, if, you know, I really have to make sure that I'm perfect in every way.
Yeah.
I mean, we always have a great time, so I want to come in. We have a nice chat, we have a hug, we talk about life, you know. We spill the tea, like...
Whatever, it's not busy. Because my boss will kill me.
Yeah, it's just a lot of times. I'm always like... I think I remember one time, I don't know what her name is, but the person behind the counter was like, said to my... I had a friend with me, and he was like, I think they're just having a photo shoot in there rather than doing the piercing.
Listen, if it's not busy, because yeah.
Do you have any horror stories from your past? Either like a customer came in with like a really horrendous thing that went wrong.
It happened in the past when I had a customer coming in. Oh, I think my piercing is rejecting. And I'm like, it rejected probably a while ago. What it's staying on is your literally hair. I will just wipe it. And this is your piercing. And I had a customer from abroad with infected cheek piercings and so. The medical professionals didn't know what to do with it, so I just gently helped them out and I scooped out the because they had pockets filled with pus.
Oh here, god, okay.
You know? So when I just gently scooped it out, it was like a bit...
Ew!
It was a lot, it was really a lot. I had a customer for a gentle piercing, female, and people don't clean themselves. Okay, so at least let's clean it, right? And then the customer tells you, why is it taking so long? And I'm like, because I need to clean it.
That is gross.
You know what I mean? Yeah, yes, yes. And then you're like, when they would leave and you tell them to clean it afterwards, will they clean it?
I doubt
it. What if it will get infected? They will blame you for it or what, you know?
So you have had several piercings and stuff in the past. You don't have as many now. And well, when I first met you, you had your big gauges in your ears. So I'll put some photos so you can see what Veronica looked like a while ago. What makes you like get lots of get loads and then take them out and then like what, you know, because I always get asked that kind of question, like, will I have them forever or whatever, but like you just kind of don't know. So I don't know what your experience has been with them.
Because life is a journey. At the time, I thought that's best for me and I really liked it, but some of the piercings didn't work for me. They were changing my facial features in a way I don't like it.
Uh-huh.
And on top of that, I had a facial feminization surgery.
Oh, so yeah,
I had to remove my horn implants, you know, I had to remove my piercings and everything.
I mean, I've never met anyone before who's had gauges that size. So what size were they, the biggest?
12 centimeters.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah, when we were in the pub and my friends were joking, you know, I was like, I was taking them out and you can put your beer on it.
When you get to a certain size of that, how do you stretch them bigger? Do you just have to use weights?
When I used to live in Poland, we didn't have anything in that size, you know, so when I was stretching it, I think the largest jewelry was like 3 centimeters and I was 5 at that time already and I was like, you know what, let's get something. So, you know, I did it all, like shampoo bottles.
Oh,
know, like,
God! Do you like my PC?
Cut it, you know, like, oh yeah, it works, you know, just so you can go forward with it.
They must have been really heavy.
You feel them, but basically when I was going out and I wanted to dance, I was like...
Okay.
Because yeah, if so, I could kill someone. Yeah. They were not as heavy as people thought they were.
Okay.
Because I didn't feel them, the weight of them.
What are some misconceptions when it comes to modified people? Obviously, I mean, I can chime in this as well, but what are some things that people say to you that are like ridiculous, that just aren't true, or, you know, instant judgments that people make?
Oh, Jesus. Like, people think that you have to take drugs, even if for some people it's wrong. I'm drug free. I don't condemn use of drugs because I think like if people want to take something or do whatever they want, yeah, as long as they know there is, it's none of my business.
Yeah,
it's their body.
Yeah,
but that's what people think. Back in the day when I was living in Poland, then people were constantly like presuming things, like,
yeah,
I went to school and obviously the next day one of the teachers, oh, you know that they were talking about you in the teacher's room. I was like, oh really, what? They were, yeah, because they were asking me, are you like into this, you know, craziness, are you aggressive, you know, do you do drugs and stuff? And I'm like, well, yeah, I'm vegan, straight edge, and yeah, what else do you want? They were expecting the drama and I'm like,
no, she needs a cult.
yeah but people have got this weird impression that you might, I don't know, eat babies, you know, burn cats, you know.
That's my Saturday night, basically. When I still worked in retail, and I worked in Morrison's still, I had a customer come up to me and literally say, do you know where I can buy magic mushrooms? And I was like, what? He was like, well, I just thought I'd ask, because you know.
Yeah.
I was like, you know what? You know what? Yeah. Oh my God, okay, yeah. Ronnie, oh my fucking God. I am so over people saying to me, oh, airport security must love you. You just walk through! Yes. You can't go on the plane, you look too scary. Like in 20 years time, 20, 30 years time, what do you kind of see modifications going to? Because I kind of see it as like fake arms and metal and chips being implanted that can help you see better.
Prosthetics, that's what they're developing. Implants which can measure your temperature and so on and so on. So yeah, things like that will happen. Like implants which are not just aesthetic, but are also useful.
Mm-hmm.
Like even now I put my magnetic implant, you know, I can pick up.
I was about to ask you about that, if it was in there.
Yeah, it helps me to pick up things. The other day I was repairing a phone for a friend, you know, I was like, screw.
So what finger is it in this
one? This one, yeah. You can feel it, you can see it. Might feel it a bit.
So a question that I always get as well is, do days help? Because I've got my day pierced now. Obviously, Veronica did it. And people, ever since I got it, was like, oh, has this stopped your headaches, stopped your migraines? So I'm like, I never thought that was even a thing. Like, where did that come from?
All of those myths come from some bullshit which someone posted somewhere. Hey, yeah. I got this piercing and my migraine went away. There are no scientific facts for that.
Yeah.
Some people said it helped them. Some people said it didn't. So the best thing to do is check it on your own.
Yeah, do it.
Do it. The questions I get, baby, is like, oh, I'm getting my tragus piercing. I've heard that you can lose eyesight. and I'm like, is this...
That'd be a clickbait title. My date made me blind.
Yeah. Is there a camera? Is someone recording this? It's like when people come in for a piercing, they expect it to be this horrible experience because they've seen it on YouTube.
Yeah. My reaction videos don't help that. I was kidding. People always say to me, oh, I'm so scared. And I'm like, literally, this is like a minority. Like,
yeah, and then you come in, it's like, boom, 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 done. Things, yeah. Like, you know.
Well, thank you so much for coming onto my channel. I am so happy that we've eventually been able to do this. We are going to be filming another video as well, but that'll be in a few weeks. But thank you. I'm going to give you a nice hug.
Thank you.
And I will put Veronica's links, like her Instagram, down in the description. So you go follow her. Make sure you go subscribe, follow and everything, and, you know, stalk, all that good stuff.
Perfect.
Make sure you hit the like button, because that's really helped me out. All the social media links are down below as well. Be as amazing, baby. Everything will be done. Make sure they take on with you, because you are flawless. Yes. Hi guys, thank you so much for making it to the end of the video. I want to give an extra special shout out to my patrons: Kiri Roseberry, Galaxy Star Fire, Curtis Mitchell, Nikki NG, Michelle Erickson, Kelly Bowser, Fred Monster, Kia, Catherine Lamb, and Philippa Clark. Thank you so much for becoming my top tier patrons. There's a link down below if anyone else would like to join the family. Yes. Thank you. Bye.